Good morning to all. Today we are going to learn English grammar, present continuous tense. In the previous class, we have seen what is simple present tense. The simple present tense tells us about actions that are done regularly or as a matter of habit. And do you remember the form of simple present tense? That is, we add yes or es to the first form of the verb. And we use do or does to make the sentences interrogative. And today's class is the continuation of present tense, that is present continuous tense. We use the present continuous tense to say that an action is taking place at the time of speaking. Look at these examples. The children are flying kites. They are washing the car. The girls are eating. The teacher is teaching. So all these sentences are in the present continuous tense. You can notice in the sentences there are two types of verbs are used. One is helping verb, that is or are, and another one is main verb, that is flying, washing, eating and teaching. In each sentence, first form of the verb plus ing has been used after is or are. So present continuous tense is formed as subject plus helping verb, that is, am, are, plus first form of the verb plus ing. So remember children, we add helping verb plus ing with the main verb in all the continuous tenses. Look at this table to understand the structure of present continuous tense. Examples for declarative sentence. I am playing, he is playing, you are playing. Here you can see that am is used with I only. Is used with all singular subjects except I and you. Are is used with all plural subjects. And you is always treated as plural. Next is, how do we form negative sentence? Negative form of the present continuous tense is formed by adding not after helping verb is, am or are. For example, I am not playing. He is not playing. We are not playing. Then for interrogative form of present continuous tense is formed by adding is or am or are to the beginning of the sentence, that is by placing it before the subject. For example, am I playing? Is he playing? Are we playing? Here one thing you have to remember, that put question mark at the end of the sentence. It is very important, you should not avoid that. So let's discuss exercise. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of verb given in the brackets. First one, the bell dash ringing. Here the subject is singular, so we use the singular form of verb, that is. Second one, the birds dash eating grains. Here the birds refer plural noun, so we use the plural form of verb, that is are. Third one, the doctor dash treating the patients. Here the doctor means singular, so we use the singular verb, that is. Fourth one, some women dash sowing seeds in the fields. Some women means more than one, it's plural, so we use the plural form of verb are. So same way you complete the rest of the sentences. Hope you're clear about this part. Now let's see the uses of present continuous tense. We use the present continuous tense to talk about actions that are happening at the moment of speaking. For example, we are learning English now. They are reading their books. Next, we use to talk about activities continuing only for a limited time. For example, he is staying with his uncle for a week. I am going to be in Chicago for a few months. We use present continuous tense to talk about future plans. For example, I am going to New York next week. We are meeting at the mall. Children, you have to remember some rules while changing the verb into present continuous tense. Let's have a look on that. When we add ing to the verb, sometimes there is no other change in the spelling. For example, eat, eating, go, going, rain, raining, open, opening. When a verb ends in E, we replace the E with ING. For example, drive, driving, dance, dancing, take, taking, bake, baking. When a verb ends in IE, the IE changes to Y. Then we add ING. For example, die, dying, tie, tying, lie, lying. For some verbs that end in a consonant, the last letter is repeated and ing is added. For example, put, putting, travel, traveling, begin, beginning. So you must remember these things while changing verb into present continuous tense. So let's see this exercise. Add ing to these verbs and write them correctly. Run, running. Here, the last letter is repeated. That is N. Then second one, speak, speaking. Here we add ing only. Then third one, aim, aiming. There is no change in the spelling. Then fourth one, hit, hitting. Here we repeated the last letter. That is double T. Hope you understood this exercise. Next we are going to discuss one more exercise, that is rewrite each of the sentences once as an interrogative sentence and then as a negative sentence. Mala is practicing the guitar. How do you form this sentence into interrogative? We place that helping verb before the subject, that is to the beginning of a sentence. So the answer is Mala practicing the guitar? Then how do you form this sentence into negative? We use not after the helping verb. That is, Mala is not practicing the guitar. Second one, they are visiting us tonight. Are they visiting us tonight? They are not visiting us tonight. Here you have to be very careful in the interrogative sentence. Use question mark at the end of the sentence. So hope you understood today's class. All of you go through this chapter and understand the rules. Do your exercises carefully. We continue to learn grammar in next week also. Thank you. Have a nice day.